Hi, I'm John. Welcome to this Math Minute. In today's Math Minute, I'm going to talk about the role that memory plays when we learn math. There are several ways that memory can have an impact on a student's level of engagement and their achievement in math. Research in psychology has shown that people who know more, who have a deeper background knowledge of any field, and who've stored this knowledge in their long-term memories, tend to be better problem solvers in that field than people whose knowledge is not as deep. For example, in a famous 1987 study of reading by Rex and Leslie, students who were weaker readers outperformed students who were stronger readers on tests of comprehension because they knew more about baseball, which was the subject of the passages they had to read. Similarly, in math, students who have a deeper knowledge of number facts and computational strategies and who can quickly recall this information when they need it, tend to be better problem solvers. For example, a student who can't remember their multiplication facts, or who doesn't have efficient strategies for generating facts, will have trouble solving problems. They'll struggle to see patterns and make connections, to make estimates and predictions, and even to perform basic calculations. When students encounter new information or facts as they're solving a problem, they store this information in their short-term memory. Unfortunately, human short-term memory is very weak. Most people can only remember a random sequence of seven numbers when they first see the sequence. That's why students who haven't committed basic facts and strategies to long-term memory often struggle in math. They'll have trouble integrating new knowledge or reorganizing new information because their short-term memories are weak and can only process a limited amount of information. Students who've stored foundational knowledge in their long-term memories can easily access this knowledge when they need it and have more spare mental capacity to devote to thinking about the problem. That's why students who know and can recall more tend to be better problem solvers. There are fun, engaging, and effective methods of teaching that educators and parents can use to help students remember math and develop a foundational knowledge of the subject. I'll talk more about these methods in my Math Minute video that busts the myth that math is not supposed to be fun.
I hope you've enjoyed this Math Minute. I'll see you next time.